This summer, the city was once again hard at work trying to contain another menace to urban forests. With the worst of the mountain pine beetle having come and gone, and their program against the spruce budworm out of the way, they then turned their attention to the Douglas fir tussock moth, another one of the resident pests we simply have to deal with.
It's not like it's an invasive species. It is out there, but because we've lost so many trees to the pine beetle, now that we've got tussock moth giving us problems, of course there's concern there because we want to have some tree canopy. And really with the tussock moth, when the numbers get quite high, they can wipe out stands of trees as they have in some areas of Kamloops already.
Barnhart Vale was particularly hard hit, as well as regions outside the city up the North Thompson. This year, the focus was an aerial spraying of Peterson Creek, Rose Hill, Aberdeen, and Dufferin, mainly Kenneth Cartwright Park, having hit those regions hard in mid-June.
We might have expected them out a little bit earlier, but when we planned initially to spray them, they were still just hanging around and weren't doing the feeding that they needed to. So with BTK, the product that we're using, it has a fairly narrow window that has to be ingested, so it has to be sprayed when the little insect, the little caterpillar, is actively feeding.
So all that early morning helicopter activity some residents were noticing was just the spraying process, and there is nothing to fear from the spray itself.
The BTK, the naturally occurring bacteria that we're using, it's next to no toxicity other than to the little caterpillars that we're targeting. And even the solution that it's mixed in, it's molasses, which again is benign or no toxicity there. So that hopefully will help alleviate any concerns that folks had. And it had to be done really early in the morning when the winds were low and the humidity was at the right level, because there's no point in going through this whole process unless it's going to have the best effects possible.
This latest battle in urban forestry is just a part of what's been a large-scale war against a trio of troublesome insects.
With our treatment programs, for instance, the mountain pine beetle, there weren't that many treatment options. Once the tree was hit, it was pretty much hit. Some people seemed to have some success, but the city as a whole didn't have a spray option. With the spruce budworm in 2008, we sprayed 400 hectares in Kenneth Cartwright, and continuing to monitor that, and things seem to be at low to medium levels, so that's where we want it to be. In 2009, we sprayed the tussock moth and some spruce budworm that happened to be in the area, and we're not spraying that again this year, so things seem to be working out pretty good with that spray. So that's why we are moving ahead with the program and the options that we can, and they seem to be having success.
100% eradication of the tussock moth isn't likely, but reduction to a more natural level will go a long way to preserving existing stands of Douglas fir. As a resident, if you spot the tussock moth, here's what you can do.
You can try hosing them off and knocking them down, sweeping them up, putting them in a garbage bag and disposing of it at the landfill. You don't want to handle those little caterpillars very much. Some people react to it and have a reaction called tussocosis. You can also use BTK, like the city is using. It's a naturally occurring bacteria that is quite effective. And if there are other options, and we would advise consulting with a professional to maybe try some other options too.